All right, dobry dzień, everyone. It's Professor Mesropova here with another introduction to the basics of the Russian language. Today, we will continue exploring the Cyrillic alphabet, and we'll try to read a few signs that I think you will recognize without even knowing a single Russian letter. Let's see how it goes. Here comes the first sign, and I'm guessing that by the looks of the golden arches, you all know exactly what the sign says. However, since we're interested in the Cyrillic letters, let's go ahead and read the name of this fast food chain letter by letter. If you've been watching my previous videos, you already know that each Russian letter stands for a sound. So as long as you know what sound a letter makes, you can read any Russian word. The name begins with M, followed by A, so MA. Note that the name on the sign uses a lowercase letter A, while I'm using the capital letter just to show you both versions. This next letter makes the sound of k, so altogether we have mak. Moving along, d, o, makdo, n. Again, this letter is not to be confused with the Latin letter h, makdon, a, makdona. This letter here makes the sound of l, d, and s, McDonald's. So here we go, guys. We just spelled out McDonald's. All right, let's read the name of another chain that I'm assuming most of you, certainly all coffee lovers, have recognized immediately. You've seen some of these letters already, starting with S, T, A, STA. This next letter is new and is not to be confused with the Latin letter P. This letter corresponds to the Russian rolling R sound. I know that the rolling R might be a difficult sound for some of you, so I'll make sure to make a separate video dedicated to it. Okay, moving along. B, A, Starba, K, S, Starbucks. The stress falls on the first A, so here we have Starbucks. Let's move along to the Russian word for coffee. So we have K, O, Ko. This next letter makes a F sound. The letter itself probably makes you think of the Greek alphabet. If you recall, I mentioned in another video that the Russian alphabet was devised by two Greek monks. And lastly, we have Ye. So Ko-fe, Ko-fe. Note that the letter Ye makes the previous consonant soft. It's F and not F. Linguists call this phenomenon palatalization. Most Russian consonants come in pairs, hard and soft. This is something we can talk about later as well. But for now, here you go, guys. Starbucks coffee. One last sign for today. I won't help you read it this time. See if you can figure out what the sign says on your own. Please let me know in the comments below if you were able to read it.